And good evening, everyone. A big thank you to all the panelists for joining us this evening. Let us get going. I hope the technology supports us. Very interesting topic, hiring in the times of COVID, the skills, the competencies, and what kind of people we would be looking for. In fact, it's a very important inflection in the history of humankind. So much has changed. So many models are being redefined. So many things are being redefined, reoriented, recalibrated in the space of human resources. And therefore, what does it mean for the competencies, for the skills, for the attitudes, and what kind of people the industry is looking for? And who could have been the better set of people than the ones who have joined us this afternoon? So once again, a big thank you to all of you, the panelists. Just to get an overview and get some comprehensive sense about the competencies, the emerging set of competencies. Mr. Sahadev, may I request you by asking to share your thoughts, your take on how the competencies have been shaping, reshaping, and what is the likely scenario that is going to emerge with respect to the changing requirements of the competencies? I know you have a presentation you wish to share with us, and we would really love to hear your thoughts, and then we'll get into the discussion with other co-panelists. So over to you, Mr. Sahadev. Thank you once again.
Good evening, everyone. It is such a pleasure to be sharing my thoughts and my compliments to J.K. Singhania Kamlapath University, Lakshmipath, J.K. Lakshmipath University. So basically, I have a small presentation because I have seen in the last 15 months that when you are connecting virtually and if you are not sharing screens, probably people are at different levels. So with permission, I'll share a couple of slides. So what competencies are, so basically what I...
Mr. Sahadev, you can make it full view. You can put it on slide view mode.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
So, what is the importance of professional education or the training is like when in army, you join army, you are made competent, you are made fighting fit. So similarly, when you are in the professional universities, are you getting a corporate worthy professional? Are you becoming a corporate worthy professional? So there are skills, we are talking in the COVID times, but there are certain skills which are very necessary, and in the core, if people are not carrying vision, so vision for self will actually drive the entire thing in my view. And if we know where we want to be and then what actions we are taking will actually create the kind of scenes for us. So these are a couple of competencies which I wish to talk about. One is the functional, which get developed and which get focused the most, but then there are other competencies. But in case there are other competencies which are knocked out about, which is communication and presentation, it doesn't work, the teamwork, the digital literacy, or the learnability, flexibility, and adaptability, creativity, and the most of all is the attitude. But the center of the entire thing remains the vision for self. So the depth of knowledge, definitely it matters, and without it does not work. And not only the depth, but the breadth of knowledge will also really make things work for you. The second most important is any great manager, unless you're communicating or you're creating the similar ideas in the minds of others, you cannot really succeed. And in this world, whether you are working in small team or big teams, actually you are part of the entire system. And in case you are not there, some of most of the things will not work for you. Digital literacy definitely is another thing which will make things efficient and will solve a couple of complex problems for you. And the fifth one being, in today's world, any knowledge is getting outdated in case you are not learning and adapting, and you are flexible to other ideas, and you're not adapting to the situation, you are becoming redundant. So this is the foremost competency which will take you forward. And the next one is creativity. So doing things differently. And most of all is the attitude. It will decide actually the altitude. And can-do attitude can really. But during these COVID times, what I was going to talk is, this is the most real competency which has emerged. In case you cannot show empathy to people, in case you are not ready to walk an extra mile, the things will not. Any most competent people, in case there are two these basic competencies are missing in these time, then most of the things will not work for any individual. So for the young students who are going to step into the professional world, so I divide these competencies into four different, so professional, business awareness, management skills, and the personal competencies. And some of these competencies can be looked at, and I can share the presentation because there is a limitation on time. But we should target on all these, not only these four professional competencies, but what are the strengths and what are the opportunities. And then we can work upon these. So what I am actually talking is creating the winning edge. So when we are talking of creating a winning edge, when there is a horse race, the horse which wins the race and the next one, there is only so much of a distance, so little a distance. It is a couple of milliseconds. So are we creating that kind of winning edge for our students? Are the students creating that kind of winning edge in whichever profession they are launching themselves? Even if there is a slight bit of edge, so this winning edge, which will take you extra mile ahead from the others, will actually decide your career graph. So for initial thoughts, maybe this was all. Thank you, Premji. We can move on to the next panelist.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Sahadev. And what I hear you say is, in addition to the competencies that you spoke about, like can-do attitude, learnability, digital, and you highlighted the two most important ones, that is empathy and also willingness to go the extra mile in order for you to create a winning edge.